Brr, it's cold in here. I think I need a jacket. Stay tuned. We're going to talk about hardcover jackets today. Hi, I'm MK Williams. I'm an author and independent publisher. I love sharing my insights about all things self-publishing with you. Before I get into the details of today's video, don't forget to hit subscribe. That way you can be here every week as I release new videos on self-publishing, making a career of being an author, and now being a mompreneur. And you definitely want to subscribe this week because every day I'm releasing a new video about all things related to book covers. That's right. You're going to be covered on covers this week, whether it's your front cover, your back cover, even the jacket of your jacketed hardcover. We're talking about it. That way you know what to look for, what to plan for. And if you're getting your book cover design, you kind of know what to bring to the designer. And speaking of design, this entire series of videos, this specific video is all sponsored by Formatted Books because they are launching a new cover design service. So that means you can get your book formatted by them for print and ebook, and you can get your cover done. That's huge. As a self-publisher, we have so many things to do. Being able to send our precious book baby off to Formatted Books, and then they send back the finished product and the files that we need to upload that get done correctly the first time, that's a huge time savings, huge worry savings, and you know what? The price is really reasonable. So I definitely encourage you to check out Formatted Books for not only the formatting of your books, but with their new cover design service. Tell them that MK sent you. I have a link below. Okay, so today we're going to talk about the hardcover dust jacket. Now, this is the actual jacket that wraps around either the case laminate, or in this case, this is the actual cloth. So this book was done with IngramSpark when they still offered the actual cloth. Like you can hear, there's a texture there. This is actually a cloth bound hardcover. They now do digital cloth, so it's case laminate. It just looks like cloth. But this one's actually cloth from back in the day. So you can get jacketed on your case laminate or your digital cloth now. Now, if you do the case laminate, it's a slightly different dimensions, but it's pretty much like your paperback cover design. It's just like adhered to the actual boards. But the jacket is something additional that you would design. So in this case, you know, the part that you see when you just look at the book, it looks like the paperback, right? Like it has all the same detail on the back, the side, the front cover for, you know, people to see, but the jacket has additional detail on the front and the back. So really the only vendor right now that gives you this option is IngramSpark to be able to do the jacketed case laminate or jacketed digital cloth. So definitely check those out. Now the elements for this. So we know the elements for the front, the spine, and the back. So the elements here could be a secondary description that you could put here on the interior flap. I always like that because I know some people, you know, they pick up a book. Okay, what is this about? Nice little reminder there. You can also do author bio, an image, as well as contact information. So I just had a really brief, you know, just like at 1MKWilliams, 1MKWilliams.com, and like that super brief bio I talked about. This is literally two sentences. It should not be a novella about your life. It should be very brief. You should have your nice professional, high quality resolution photo, not just something, not a selfie that you shot with your phone. Definitely, you know, this photo of me was taken with a smartphone, but it was taken like we considered lighting, we considered all the other elements. Like this was done to look professional, even though it was not professionally done, if that makes sense. But it shouldn't be a selfie. You know, it shouldn't be from the upwards onto your chin. There should be good lighting. So like keep that in mind if you're doing the photo in there. Now you may also in here instead do a call to action for more reviews. Maybe you're going to point somebody, if it's a nonfiction book, to like a course or a website. Maybe they can download digital extras from the book and you want to remind them of that. But effectively, you want to make sure you're not duplicating what was on the back cover of the book already. You want this to be new content. So I really like having that secondary description on the front flap. Again, maybe I'm not using the full description that I would have on the retailer sites on the back. So I'm saving a little and I'm kind of reworking it to fit here. So that's something that you could do. Again, I like having the headshot and bio in the back. Or if you're giving directions for next steps, that's a really great to put that. Claiming that digital extra, remind them to leave a review. It should be a short link for anything you're pointing them to. So like I would do 1mkwilliams.com/feminina for the infinite. It's part of the Feminina series. So just make sure it's unique. So you do want to make sure that whatever you're putting on these flaps is unique, and you want to make sure that it's designed. Again, you'll notice this is one image that completely wraps around, right? So if I just had this front cover image and then everything else was maybe like a solid purple, you know, there could be that really harsh line between the front and the spine when it's being printed, when it's being jacketed, that can maybe not fall the right way. It's not always going to fall right on that edge. The same goes with the flaps, right? You don't want to have too much bleed over. It doesn't look nice. So in this case, I like that it was one solid image that wrapped all the way around. So if somebody were to take off this jacket, like there wouldn't be any weird lines or breaks on it. That is something to consider. And again, a professional designer will know to do that. But if you're trying to DIY this, I totally get it. Like those are some things to consider. But again, like if you are thinking, hey, like I want a jacketed hardcover, okay, there's a lot of complexity in that as far as like getting the different sizes for the cover file and making sure it all adds up and it's going to align right. Definitely working with a professional can help at that point. Okay. Have any of you used the jacketed hardcover option with IngramSpark? Did you like it? Did you not like it? What questions do you have about hardcovers? Definitely let me know in the comments below. And if you found this information helpful at all, please give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to hit subscribe. And don't forget to go over and check out Formatted Books. They really are offering a great service and I'm truly grateful to them for sponsoring this video and this entire series of videos. All right, stay tuned because tomorrow we're going to talk about some of the differences between professionally designed book covers, some DIY book covers, and kind of my own evolution with how my covers were done. Okay, so stay tuned for that.